Mr. Latham's economics back. Today we're going to talk about the shifting the curves for supply and demand. What shifts curves? Well, determinants of demand shift the demand curve. Determinants of supply shift the supply curve. One of the things, and you notice here I've made an acronym. Let me try that again. Tires. Taste, income, related goods, expectation, size of market, those are determinants of demand, and stores for supply, subsidies and taxes, technology, other related goods, resource cost, expectation, size of market. As we talk about the determinants of demand, we're talking about what people do, okay? Generally speaking, people or consumers determine the determinants of demand. Well, the determinants of supply are about business. That's really important. So if you're going to copy these down, people, generally speaking, are consumers or the determinants of demand, businesses, the determinants of supply, because these are the determinants of supply are the things that affect businesses. Okay, first we're going to talk about demand, okay? And we're going to actually go through some of these determinants and show what they do. We're talking about our product here, our tasty hamburgers. So we sell tasty hamburgers. Lots of fast food places sell tasty hamburgers. So we're talking about all the fast food places that sell tasty hamburgers. Okay, the first determinant of demand is people's personal taste. Well, let's say, for instance, all of a sudden chicken gets some bad publicity. Everybody says, man, I don't really want to be eating so much chicken. I really want to start eating some more hamburgers. Well, that's going to cause the demand for hamburgers to increase. So we shift the demand to the right. It's always a shift right or left. This will be a shift to the right. The demand for hamburgers increases at all prices. We end up with a new equilibrium. P sub 1, our new price. Q sub 1, our new quantity. And what we see is, if demand increases, we have a situation where both price increases and the quantity demanded also increases. Right here, right? The price has gone up and the quantity demanded has also gone up. What happened to supply? Nothing. The curve's the same. But what happened to the quantity supplied? Well, at this equilibrium, the quantity supplied was right here and was the Q sub E. At the new equilibrium, the quantity supplied, it comes up to here, and it's actually increased. So even though supply is unchanged, the quantity that businesses supplied has increased. That's the difference between a curve shift and a change in quantity supplied. Okay, so an increase in demand, which is talking about that entire curve, causes a change in quantity supplied or an increase in quantity supplied. Okay, there's taste. How about income? Everybody in the United States starts making more money. What are they going to buy more of? They're going to buy more tasty hamburgers. Why? Because they have more money to do it. The more money you have, the more stuff you can buy. So that it's going to look exactly the same as this graph does right here. So we're good. Same thing. It's a change in an increase in income will cause demand to increase. Okay, related goods. Well, what's a related good for a tasty hamburger? Well, I don't know about you, but when I order a tasty hamburger, I get fries and a Coke. They're related goods. So all the fast food places do 50% off fries and Cokes with the purchase of any hamburger. Am I going to buy any more hamburgers? Heck yes, I am. It's going to increase the demand. Same thing we've got right here. It's going to increase the demand for tasty hamburgers. Even though fries and Cokes aren't hamburgers, they're related goods. You can't hardly eat a hamburger without a fries and a Coke. Okay, compliments. Okay, a compliment. That was a compliment we just talked about. Okay, that was a compliment. So fries and Cokes are compliments to tasty hamburgers. Now, that was right here, compliments. Okay, everybody see that? Substitutes, next. Substitutes. What's a substitute for a hamburger? Well, a chicken sandwich probably would be. Chicken all of a sudden gets a really bad reputation. What are people thinking? Well, you know what? I don't want chicken anymore. I could, you know, sometimes I get a hamburger, sometimes I get a chicken. I'm not feeling very good about chicken anymore. Hamburger is a substitute for chicken. People are going to purchase more hamburgers instead of chicken because they're substitutes for each other. So same graph again, an increase in the cost or a bad anything bad happens to chicken since it's a substitute. Hamburgers are a substitute for chicken. People will purchase more hamburgers. Not everyone, but lots of people. Okay, so all of these things all did the same thing. We kept increasing demand, which shifted the demand curve to the right. And right over here, an increase in demand causes both price and quantity demanded to increase. Okay, let's talk about the last two. Expectations. Okay, everybody expects the price of hamburgers that there's going to be a big sale on hamburgers in a few days. What might they want to do? Well, they're going to say, you know what? I was going to go get a hamburger today, but it's going to cost me, you know, it's going to cost me $5. And I heard you're going to buy one, get one free on Saturday. What are they going to do? They're going to demand fewer hamburgers. Now, once the sale goes on, that's a totally different thing. But right now, we're talking about they're expecting this to change. It hasn't changed yet. They're going to demand fewer hamburgers, causing demand to go down or shift to the left. We get a new price, okay, and we get a new quantity. The price decreases, the quantity decreases. So if the demand for tasty hamburgers declines, then the price is going to decline and the quantity demanded is also going to decline. So, in other words, a decrease in demand causes both a decrease in price and quantity demanded. Okay, size of the market. Eglin closes. What's going to happen to the demand for tasty hamburgers in the Fort Walton Beach area? Well, Eglin has a bunch of people. There'll be less people. The market will be smaller. The fewer people are going to demand fewer hamburgers. The demand will shift down. It'll shift to the left. Same thing you can see right here. So both price and quantity are going to decrease. So what you can see is the determinants of demand are pretty much all about people, right? Customers. And if it helps the demand, then the demand shifts right or increases. And if it hurts the demand, then the demand shifts left or decreases. All right, let's transition to supply. Okay, we have six determinants of supply here. We'll go through them quickly. Okay, when we talk about subsidies is a negative tax on a product. And then when they talk about taxes here, we're not talking about income taxes, we're talking about taxes on companies. Okay, so it could be a tax on a product. For instance, there's a tax on gas. There's a subsidy for wheat and corn. In this case, let's assume that the United States decides to subsidize hamburgers. Well, what's going to happen if you subsidize hamburgers? Well, businesses now can make more hamburgers and they're going to get extra money, so they're going to supply more hamburgers. And an increase in supply doesn't go up, okay? It does not do that, okay? Doesn't do that. An increase shifts to the right, okay? If you went up, you'd actually see that we'd sell less. Well, here, or you'd supply less. Here, you supply more. Well, what happens when businesses supply more hamburgers? Well, what happens to price? It goes down. What happens to quantity? Well, if they're supplying more, you'd expect the quantity to go up, and in fact, it does. Okay, this all makes sense as you start understanding and getting into it. So the supply increases, which causes the price to go down. There's more available, but it causes the quantity supplied to increase. Right? Here we go. There to here. It's increased. Once again, what happened to demand? Nothing. Okay, the demand curve's unchanged. Did the quantity demanded change? Yes, it did. It went from right here to right here. It increased. So the quantity demanded changed, but the demand did not change because demand's the entire curve. There's a new machine. It makes these hamburgers really quickly and requires people to hardly do anything at all. What are suppliers of hamburger going to do? Well, this is going to save them money. They're going to be able to do it faster. They're going to supply more hamburgers. The exact same situation. It's good for businesses. They supply more. Okay? Other related goods. Well, most hamburger places also sell chicken sandwiches. Okay? Let's assume that chicken sandwiches become much more expensive, okay, to purchase and all. Well, what's a hamburger place going to do? Are they going to say, well, they're more expensive, but we'll just have to deal with it? Or are they likely to start supplying more hamburgers in order to make up for, you know, because they can make more money on hamburgers than they can make on chicken, everything else being equal, okay? And the answer is yes, they're going to supply more hamburgers because now chicken's more expensive. It's harder to, it's something they could do. They just don't want to do as much. And so once again, we're going to increase the supply of tasty hamburgers, and it's going to cause both the price to go down and the quantity supplied to increase. Okay, now let's look at the flip side. Okay, next thing we're talking about resource costs. Well, what's a resource what's a resource for hamburgers? Well, a resource would be hamburger meat. The price of hamburger meat skyrockets. Well, if you got to pay a lot more for hamburger meat, are you going to supply more hamburgers or less hamburgers? We're going to supply less. Okay? So we shift the supply to the left. The price goes up. And what do you expect is going to happen with the quantity? Well, if you're supplying less, the quantity is going to go down, right? And in fact, it does. Okay? So if supply decreases, that causes price to increase, right? There's less available and people still want it. And so the price is going to end up going up, but fewer people are going to purchase these. Okay? You're going to sell less because of the increase in resource costs. Expectations. Okay, the hamburger business expects that hamburger is going to become in short supply. Well, think about that, okay? You're afraid you're going to run out of hamburgers, which is really bad for a hamburger place, right? What do? Well, you supply less so you don't run out. What happens when you supply less? The price goes up and you sell less, which if you're worried you're going to run out of hamburgers, that's probably not a bad thing because you don't want to run totally out. Same thing, right? So the supply decreases, the price goes up, the quantity of supply decreases. Remember, back to old demand. What's happened to demand here? Nothing. The curve stays exactly where it is, but the quantity demanded was here at Q sub E. It's now moved to here at Q sub 1. It's declined, okay? So the quantity or the demand hasn't changed, but the quantity demanded did. And then finally, size of market, okay? In this case, let's say we have 10 fast food places all sell tasty hamburgers in our area. Two of them close. What's going to happen to the supply of hamburgers? Well, if you only have 8 stores selling hamburgers instead of 10, those 8 stores are going to supply less than the 10 did. Supply is going to decline, just like we've shown in the graph right here. So you can see that all the determinants of supply, we're talking about business, 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 business. With the determinant of demand, we're talking about people or consumers. So the consumers affect, the people that want to buy things affect demand. The people that are providing or supplying items affect supply. Makes perfect sense. You want to know these determinants and be able to list at least most of them. See you next time.